The U.S. Air Force has tested an air-breathing hypersonic engine whose thrust production beat all the previous engines of this type. The Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, announced this on August 5, 2019, but did not disclose when the test was carried out. The scramjet engine is developed by Northrop Grumman for AFRL. Pat Nolan, Northrop Grumman's Vice President for Missile Products, said in a statement, "The series of tests on this fighter engine-sized scramjet was truly remarkable. The scramjet successfully ran across a range of hypersonic Mach numbers for unprecedented runtimes, demonstrating that our technology is leading the way in delivering large-scale hypersonic platforms to our warfighters. This is an important development since the U.S. military is actively pursuing hypersonic technology and is virtually in a race with Russia and China in this sector." In this video, Defense Updates reports on the successful test of highest thrust-producing hypersonic scramjet engine by the U.S. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank or aircraft and 3 days of premium account. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently 2 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. First is using hypersonic glide vehicle, HGV. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using ballistic missile or an aircraft where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and the scramjet engine takes over, accelerating it to hypersonic speeds as it glides back to Earth towards its intended target. Second is using a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engine can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missiles to reach hypersonic speeds. These engines have no moving parts, like the compressors and turbines used in the turbofan engines found on conventional jet planes. They rely on huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. In this method, a rocket booster is used to accelerate the missile to hypersonic speed. Then the scramjet engine kicks in and enable the missile to fly at sustained hypersonic speed. The latest test is using scramjet methodology. As per reports, Air Force Research Laboratory and Northrop Grumman have tested an 18-foot-long fighter engine-sized scramjet engine. The test has been carried out for 9 months and was conducted at the Arnold Engineering Development Complex's AEDC, Aerodynamic and Propulsion Test Unit at Arnold Air Force Base in Tennessee. The engine ran for a total of 30 minutes across an unspecified number of tests and was able to generate up to 13,000 pounds of thrust under conditions in which it will experience speeds of above 4 Mach. It's important to note that the Air Force's statement described the engine running at conditions above Mach 4, though as explained earlier, speed is considered hypersonic when it's 5 Mach and above. So we can assume that during the whole tenure of testing, some tests were carried out to replicate conditions of 5 Mach and above. Viewers may note that the 18-foot hypersonic engine is similar in size to fighter jet engines, and 13,000 pounds of thrust is much less compared to traditional ones. For example, 16-foot 11-inch Pratt & Whitney F-119 engine used in F-22 Raptor produces 35,000 pounds of thrust. so on paper the test seems to be nothing special. But the fact is that the scramjet engine is designed to generate the thrust in extremely high altitude, where the air is much thinner and the conditions are extremely harsh. The engine, if used in conditions similar to cruise altitude of a typical fighter jet, will exceed the performance of current crop of jet engines. To give the viewer perspective, so that the real stature of the achievement can be gauged, we can compare it with the Boeing's X-51A Waverider hypersonic test. SJY-61 engine, which powered the Waverider and was being tested by AFRL between 2005 and 2013, produced a maximum of 1,000 pounds of thrust. Countries like Russia, China, and the US have been developing sophisticated layered air defense. These systems are difficult for traditional aircraft and missiles to penetrate. For example, Russia has deployed S-400 air defense system. S-400 Triumph is an anti-aircraft weapon system developed by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau in the 1990s as an upgrade of the S-300 family. It's been in service with the Russian Armed Forces since 2007. It's designed to defend against aircraft, including 5th-generation stealth fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and even ballistic missiles. S-400 can track hundreds of targets at a time, engage up to 36 targets in parallel, and simultaneously launch 72 missiles. Russia is also working on S-500, which will be even more potent. U.S. fields several systems that are designed to intercept ballistic as well as cruise missiles like THAAD, or Terminal High Altitude Area Defense, which is designed to shoot down short, medium, and intermediate range ballistic missiles in their terminal phase. U.S. Navy also has a large number of Ticonderoga class and Arleigh Burke class warships which have the Aegis combat system. Aegis ballistic missile defense, which is part of the Aegis combat system, is designed to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and before re-entry. It uses standard missiles like SM-3 and SM-6 to shoot down incoming threats. On the surface, missile defense looks like a defensive weaponry, but it can disturb the MAD equilibrium. Mutually Assured Destruction, MAD, is a doctrine of military strategy and national security policy in which a full-scale use of nuclear weapons by two or more opposing sides would cause the complete annihilation of both the attacker and the defender. It's based on the theory of deterrence, which holds that the threat of using strong weapons against the enemy prevents the enemy's use of those same weapons. This balance will be disturbed if any country is able to field a fully functional missile defense system that can defend against the enemy's missile. This is where hypersonic weapons come in. Their extreme speed and ability to fly in unpredictable paths give them a high probability of penetrating the air defenses. They'll be very hard to track, let alone intercept. It's to be noted that traditional ballistic missiles also reach hypersonic speed when they descend on the target, but they follow a predictable, predefined parabolic path, which could lead to possible interception by anti-ballistic missile defense systems. The characteristic of hypersonic weapons makes it suitable for neutralizing well-defended strategic military assets. These weapons may also be used in neutralizing incoming enemy missiles, where they'll be used as interceptors. Russia is leading the hypersonic weapon space currently. It's claimed that it's already fielded a scramjet engine-based hypersonic missile named Kinzhal, and is very close to having an operational hypersonic boost glide vehicle named Avangard. The Kinzhal, or Dagger, was one of the weapons the Russian President Vladimir Putin unveiled in his State of the Nation address last year. Kinzhal reportedly has a range of approximately 1,250 miles or 2,000 kilometers, and a top speed of Mach 10. That's more than 10 times the speed of sound. According to the Russian president, units in the country's southern military district, which borders Ukraine and the Black Sea, have deployed the missiles operationally. China is thought to be pursuing hypersonic weapons, as well as made some progress with hypersonic glide vehicle, HGV, approach. The United States is working on both the approaches for developing its hypersonic weapons and may have different working prototypes by 2021. It's evident that hypersonic weapons will be one area that will see a lot of work in coming days, and the nation that will be able to operationally deploy hypersonic weapons on different platforms will have an edge in future battles. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.